Utah, Lavelle Edwards Stadium, home to the 1984 national champion, BYU Cougars, and this, one of the more intimidating venues in all of college football. We believe we've got a great one in store today, and we've got a team that makes it into the top 25. Now when you go on the road, that's when you prove you belong. As we'll see, the number 18 team in the country, the Oklahoma State Cowboys, taking on another team from the Big 12, the BYU Cougars. For EA Sports College Football, I'm Reese Davis, joined here in the booth, as always, by David Pollack and Jesse Palmer. Guys, let's tee this one up. The Cowboys will kick it away to start us off. From inside his own 10, he'll try to help out their field position. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. So the BYU Cougars offense will get the first swing of the game. And here he comes, guys, the man who makes everything go.
Everything in this offense is built around his ability. He's got such great field vision. He's got it all, man.
He is must-watch TV. Let's not get it twisted. People show up to this stadium, people are watching back at home because of this guy right here.
After picking up a couple at 2nd and 8. He's got it again. Smashes through. And he won't quite get there. But boy, after that pickup, just a few inches to go for the first. An array of possibilities here. Just need a few inches on 3rd down to move the sticks on this opening drive. To the ground to try to move the chains. The ball's free. Defense coming up with a huge fumble recovery.
And I tell you what, man, you gotta do a better job of taking care of the football. I gotta know, I got the 1st down. Running backs, this is job security. You better handle that thing well, Palmer.
And because of that, David, you might see another running back jog out in the field the next time this offense takes it. We're seeing a lot more of that around college football now. There's a lot of committees out there, committee approach. One way to get yourself on the bench very quickly, put the rock on the ground. It's a coachable lesson for that young man.
The RPO, fire complete to the left. And he'll pick up one. It brings up 2nd and 9. Stuck with a running game on 1st down. Now here they come again. The lone back's got it. And a nice run there before the defense finally makes the stop.
Keep pounding away at this defense and make them play the run. If you can get this many a chunk, they're going to have to commit more guys to the box, more guys to the run. Then you open it up for the passing game.
Here they come up to the 23-yard line, not thinking field goal, wanting to convert this 3rd and short. To the ground to try to pick up the first. And he's knocked down, but not before moving the chains.
You know, this is a running back who wants the ball, and he wants the offense to run through him. Really nice job there on the 3rd down of this opening drive for his offense. I can't wait to see what kind of game this guy's going to have.
And the Cowboys have it with a 1st and 10. Use the play fake, now to throw. Unloads to the wideout. Tremendous awareness along the sideline and the ability to get the foot down for the big pickup.
And as a quarterback, when you're facing man coverage, you've got to find your best one-on-one matchup. That receiver did a tremendous job. Quickness, changing direction, out of his break, able to create separation. There was no question the quarterback was going to target that receiver on that play.
Into the end zone he goes. Touchdown, Oklahoma State.
And I like the running back's vision. He sees the hole, explodes through it. He knows where the goal line is, gets in the end zone, gets 6.
Now they'll line up for what they hope is automatic. And he's got the extra point, and it's 7-0 to start this one. A very efficient 5-play scoring drive. And finish the deal with the short touchdown run from the 2. The kickoff team on the field as they'll send this one away. He'll bring it back from inside his 5. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. The BYU offense headed back out to go on the attack. As it turns out, the fumble on that last drive set up the touchdown, David.
And there's no bigger stat in football than turnovers. You turn the football over, they turn it into points. Jesse, that is not a recipe for success.
Good news, though, they get another chance, right? They could make amends with this drive right here. That's all that's important. You've got to execute and you've got to lock in.
Didn't get much done on that first play of the drive. It's 2nd and 11. He's looking to throw. Uncorks it. And that pass will be jarred loose on 2nd down. That brings up 3rd down.
And the big tight end, a lot of times that's a bigger strike zone, a bigger dude, and you could tell they put the hit on him, and that ball came out, and it came to the turf. Nice job playing physical by this defense.
You make up the game plan, and not a lot on the play sheet for this. 3rd and long from inside their own 20. Throws to the wideout. That is just a sideline credit. Throw, catch, toe drag, everything you want.
Well, I think on that play you saw why this guy's such a big weapon in this offense. At receiver, he does such a nice job with his routes. He's patient, and he's consistent, and he's got good hands. You don't see him put a lot of balls on the ground. Nice job there picking up the 1st down.
Some early movement along the offensive line, and they'll walk it back. The officials offer the deal, and the coach accepts it. They will take the penalty. Wide receiver now comes in motion. A jet sweep pass. The defense wouldn't let him loose, and even though it's a completion, they lost yardage.
Really good job by the defense, seeing it and going and getting it. Nice job understanding the touch pass. It could happen. Those guys go in motion, man. I got to understand, safety's got to see that, start flying down, getting ready to play that. Nice job by the defense being ready for that play.
He's going to pass on 2nd down. He makes the catch close to the sticks, but he'll be a little short of the 1st down.
And those are tough passes. When you start throwing those balls towards the sidelines, it's a longer throw for the quarterback to make. And I think that's when you see the majority of the misses for guys, the majority of the overthrows and a little bit of inaccuracy start to show itself.
On 3rd and long, hoping to throw beyond the sticks. Got him downfield. They'll move the chains. Good execution on 3rd down. They've got it at the 41. This dude is just exceptional in every facet. So fluid, such a great route runner, and a big play there.
And money down, 3rd down, find him. I mean, you want to find that matchup because he's going to win. And gets a good release, gets down the field. You see his, that's your playmaker, that's your guy. Get it to him, get the 1st down.
Off the play fake on 1st down to throw. Just masterful working that sideline and getting the toe down for the catch.
Listen, the comeback route is one of the more difficult routes.
And it looks as if they've buzzed down. Replay wants to have another peek at that last play. And the play will stand after the replay booth just does a little double checking to make sure. Leaves it with the back. And they try the middle of this stout defense, and they rise to the challenge.
Stopping the run is very high on every defensive coordinator's list, making the team one-dimensional. Nice job stuffing the run on that play right there.
They got nothing on the last play. It's 2nd and 10. They'll go right back to the run. Working his way and keeping those legs moving, picks up 5 down to the 14.
It's going to be important this offensive line is able to get a little bit of push. Just got to give this guy an inch, a little crease, and he can make yards for you.
Really need to pick up this conversion and avoid having to settle for the field goal. Snap from the gun on third down. He makes a grab. They get him stopped at the 5-yard line, but it will be first and goal from there.
It's tough on the defense there. Third down, you're in zone coverage. Everybody's watching the quarterback, and you're trying to make a break on the ball, but he just got it out of his hands too quickly, and the throw was too accurate. Really nothing you can do there, and it's now a fresh set of downs.
Keeping it on the ground on first and goal. And he takes it in for the score. Touchdown, BYU! Backed up in the shadow of their own goalpost, no problem.
When you start in the black zone inside your own 20 coming out, it's difficult. You can give up a safety. You get worried about that. The offense puts a great drive together. Great job executing. Great job getting a touchdown.
Getting set for the point after. Hit that one with some aggression for the point after. So a drive there of 85 yards, and they punctuated it with a 5-yard touchdown run. All tied up and just about set to kick it away. And he takes this from inside the 5. And he's able to pick his way through the traffic nicely for a good return on that one before he's brought down. A quick pass to the left. And he was fortunate not to lose yardage on that play, able to wedge it back to the line of scrimmage.
Really good defense. You know, you're trying to stay as close as you can to all these targets, and most importantly, those open field tackles and getting them on the ground as soon as they catch it. That's a major deal for defenses, and that was a good example there of it.
They're going to test that run defense to the right here. Nowhere to run on that one. He loses 4 on the carry.
Great running backs consistently make people miss, and he did a really good job of breaking one tackle, but he couldn't do it to the next, and to the next, and to the next. The offensive line going to have to do a lot better job, giving him some more space so he can get out in the open field and make some plays for this offense.
On third and long, you'll have to turn it loose deep, using the back as a receiver on the screen. They finally get him stopped, but what a good job by that front wall to set up the screen and create some lanes for their running back. Absolutely nothing settled. Deadlocked after one period of play as we have a look at the stats. We've got a good one going here and looking forward to keep those vibes rolling here in the second. The Cowboys have it with a 1st and 10. On the move, it's Gordon. And he found plenty of running room on that one before the defense was finally able to get him down.
Well, if at first you don't succeed, try again, right? It's been really hard for this offense in this game to run the football, but they finally break off a big run there. That could be the play they need to really generate momentum and get this run game going.
Off the play fake on 1st down to throw. Got his man downfield. Slicing and dicing through this defense, and they've got it down to the 23. They might have the defense's head spinning a little bit now. Hit him with a big run, now they hit him with a big pass.
Man, it's so hard to defend both. You know that. Which coverage do I want to put? Do I want to put more people in the box to stop the run? When you've got this kind of balance on offense, the defense can't be right.
Comes out throwing on 1st down. Fires deep toward the end zone. And he intercepts it.
And defensive backs, you think, don't have good hands. The big fella shows it. How about that defensive back going up and getting the interception? Nice job breaking on the football. You say that's why you play defense, because you don't have hands? Yeah.
BYU has it back. The Cougars ready to get into that playbook. This could be a real turning point in the game. They scored a touchdown. They got a stop. And now a chance to break the tie.
Yeah, this offense has got it cooking, man. And how about the defense? Great job getting that stop, getting the football right back to the hot hand. Now this offense, Palmer, has a chance to take the lead.
You can see the offense, too. They understand the situation right now. They were jonesing on the sidelines to get another opportunity to run back on the field. They are ready to drive this ball and go score.
Trying to make that rush think on the draw play here. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple.
Linebackers have such an amazing responsibility. Got to play run, got to play pass. How about this? Seeing the run aggressively, getting downhill, and getting in the backfield and making the tackle for a loss.
This defense has kept them backed up. Now one more stop, and they can get off the field on third and long. Throws to the tight end. A strike downfield. And they'll do more than move the chains. They'll move that thing more than 30 yards down the field before he's finally stopped.
Well, Reese, you and I were talking about this before the game. How is this defense going to be able to deal with all the speed they have offensively? You saw them just rip off a big play.
And, Jesse, now their head's spinning just a little bit. Give up a big chunk play, and it's right back at them. On the ground, it's Martin. At the 35, he's got room. Finally brought down at the 31. It's a pickup of 15 yards on the play, and they've got a first down.
First down, you know you always want to establish the running game. How about this offense? Nothing fancy. Run the football, be physical, get a big game.
This BYU offense set up with another first down. Movement here from the tight end. They're going to go right back to him on first down. They'll pick up four, second and six coming.
Just a simple power play. Again, not sexy. Run the ball up the middle. Physicality, offensive line gets to assert themselves, run block, which they love to do. This pays dividends down the road before quarter.
Solid pickup of four on first down. It's second and six. He's got it on the right. Nice pitch and catch there, and they'll have enough for the first down.
One of the things that makes this guy so dangerous is how good he is after the catch. If he's got any space around him, he's able to burst. He's able to make people miss and get extra yards for his offense. You saw it right there.
Down to the 16-yard line. It's first and 10. They're looking to pass from the red zone. Snags it over the middle. And the defense settled in to stop that one for a short gain. Going to work in the red zone, they can't pick up the first down without getting it into the end zone. On second down, wants to throw. He caught it! That completion has them right on the doorstep. They'll mark it at the one.
Wow, the quarterback knew he had to get that one to his receiver quickly on the in route. Did you see the velocity on that throw?
BYU lines up with a first and goal. They'll try to get it in with the run. And he takes it to the house. Touchdown, Cougars.
Wow, this offense, they have a lot of faith in this running back. Knowing if they get down in this area of the field, he can get it done and he can answer the bell. Two rushing touchdowns already for this offense.
Ready to try the point after. And the PAT gives them a 14-7 lead. They put together an 81-yard drive, and they capped it off with a 1-yard punt. Almost ready to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. He'll start the return inside his five. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. Oklahoma State hoping to get the pistols firing on offense. Boy, they had that last drive moving a little bit, David, but then the mistake just crushed them.
Yeah, and those mistakes are going to happen. You're going to throw the football, you're going to throw interceptions. But I think I stay aggressive with this offense. I get back to what I did on the first part of that drive, what made me successful.
I agree, David. Just turn the page if you're a quarterback, right? On this drive, you did a lot of good things there leading up to that pick. Forget about it. Move on. Play the next play.
Couldn't make the connection last time. Let's see if they throw it again. Hands it off. Plows through the defense. Picks his way ahead, pick up a three, and gets it to the 20-yard line.
You know, I think a big part of this isn't necessarily scoring a touchdown on that play, but you're just trying to get your offensive line in the rhythm of the game. Let those big fellas get lathered up.
Third down conversions are a huge stat, and this one would be a doozy if they can pull it off. Looking downfield, it's Bowman. Throws for the tight end. What a job to lay out and make the catch. Let me tell you, this senior quarterback can flat fit it in a tight window.
Man, I love those guys that are willing to put their body on the line, and he does it right here, man. Just lays out. That ball's coming in. You can see it from several yards out, making that play, laying out, keeping the football from touching the turf. Great concentration, great effort by the receiver.
They'll go back to the ground. Couldn't fight his way out of his grasp.
It's hard to run on a defense that comes off the ball like that and runs to the football like that. Good luck. No holes anywhere.
Second down here, and maybe they've got time to get one more snap off before the two-minute warning. We've reached the two-minute warning, and we have ourselves a ball game, and they have a chance to take the lead here before the half. Got stuffed on first down. It's second and 10. He's looking to throw. And that's going to fall to the ground incomplete. That was a physical matchup there. Third down coming.
We know this guy's a weapon, not just taking handoffs, but he can catch the ball too. That play, not so much. Got to do a better job reeling it in.
If they can convert here, that type of play can really give you a shot of momentum. On third and long, he's going to have to throw for it. Nowhere to go, and the ball is loose. That football must be riveted to your rib cage. How can you let it go? At least they fell on it. And the Cowboys will punt this one away. They'll look to pin him deep. He'll field the punt and look for room. That's a perfect example of not settling for a fair catch. Pick up whatever yardage you can and help out the offense. They'll throw it on first down. Pocket starts to collapse. And he can't escape, and down he goes.
And a great job by the defense, dropping in zone coverage, all eyes on the quarterback, taking away the options, and then finally the pass rush gets home, gets him on the ground.
After the big first down sack, it's second down. He's looking to throw. Getting some heat. And this defense has maxed out this pressure. Another sack. We've got a timeout here late in the first half, and they'll try to get more points on the board before the break. They're going to keep this drive going. They'll have to make a play on third and long from the 26. The give to the back. And sure, tackling there to keep him from getting to the first down marker. The defense going to stop the clock with a timeout. They want to make sure they have everybody on the same page. Looks as if BYU will have to punt it away. Three and out. They got stuck in reverse. They hope the punt can bail them out. He'll settle for some pretty good field position and make the fair catch at around the 35. Offense getting set for first down. Dropping back, it's Bowman. Unloads it left. All kinds of room to throw that one in there. And they're getting it rolling with that play to the 42-yard line. A timeout is called as this offense tries to find a way to get more points on the board before the half. He'll come out throwing on first down. Going for it all. makes the grab in the end zone. Pistols firing, touchdown Cowboys.
Yeah, and the passing game comes through, man, and we need more of that in the second half. An extra point away from tying this football game. You trailed a little bit in the first half, stayed calm. If this passing game can continue to heat up, look out in the second half.
Lining up to add another. And it's perfect. This offense prides itself on going after you, and they did with that long touchdown pass to finish off a two-play drive. After that latest answer tied things up, just about set to kick it away again. Bringing it out. I know he thinks he can house every return, but sometimes you just have to take a knee as he stopped at the 14. The BYU offense headed back out to go on the attack. He lofts it high and deep down the left side. He's got it downfield for a huge gain. Timeout called by the offense, and now they just have one remaining in the half.
Well, it didn't take long for this guy to leave his impact in the game, guys. With that catch, this guy's already over 100 yards in the game, and we're not even done the first half.
He's got his man. They'll immediately call timeout.
That's a really good example of why offensive coordinators script plays. You know the down and distance, and you know which routes can get you to the stick. So there's no wasted time. That coordinator got the play in early to his quarterback, knowing that his players were going to be able to execute.
Offense gets set for second down. Misfired on the last play. They'll go back to the air. And just too much on that pass. Too high, too wide, out of bounds and incomplete.
You know the saying, no risk it, no biscuit. If you want big plays on offense, you've got to be able to take shots. They didn't hit that one, but moving ahead in the second half, expect this offense to keep dialing them up.
They were on the move, but two straight incompletions had them staring at third and 10. From the gun, wants to pass. And he just throws it away. That is not what you're looking for on third down. Fourth down coming up.
I tell you what, I don't know if the offense was expecting man coverage that time. Third and long in field goal range, you're expecting it to be zone. Instead, they lock him up man-to-man, everybody on an island, everybody won. They get the incompletion, now setting up fourth.
They'll try to salvage a field goal on this drive. Knocked it right through, showing that big range from 48 yards out. That late in the half field goal always gives you a little boost going to the locker room, and they'll need to finish off these final few seconds and not allow them to answer. From inside the 10-yard line, he'll bring it back. And the returner could find no daylight. He goes down. They'll come out and take a knee, and that should send us to halftime. That's the end of the second quarter. That means it's time to join Kevin in our halftime update.
Fellas, looks like we've got a great atmosphere today in Provo. And I get it. A lot of coaches will say the difference between winning and losing comes down to stopping big plays and getting big plays. But if you ask me, it's more about how good you are on third down and how efficient you are in keeping drives alive. Those two stats can help you break the will of even the best defenses and help you come out on top. And with that, let's send it back to our broadcast team inside Lavelle Edwards Stadium.
BYU will try to boot it deep to start the second half. on the run from inside his own five. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. Oklahoma State has it back and the offense is on the field. They start this third quarter, one possession game, and hoping to get an early drive going.
This offense is ready, and they're ready to take the field here and see if they can get something established. They don't have to change everything and reinvent the wheel. They've had some successes in the first half, so let's get that continued here on the opening drive.
Yeah, and I love getting that break at half to go talk with my coaches and pick my offensive coordinator's brain so I know exactly what I need to do to attack this defense, and I get ball first.
At the 35, he's loose. Just a savvy, veteran, productive run from this junior.
Well, you wonder if one of the adjustments they made at halftime trailing in this game was to try and get the ground game established, David. They're off to a good start here.
Dang right. Stay patient. You don't have to worry about it. You don't have to press. Just try to get scoring drives together. Don't abandon the run.
They'll ride the hot hand.
The run game just has not been working for this offense all game long. You saw it on that last play as well. Just not getting enough push up front on the offensive line. They haven't been physical enough.
Picked up 2 yards on that last one. They need 8 on second down. They'll run play action. Caught in the backfield. It's Gordon. Makes the catch and he's brought down. Well, he made the grab, but the doors closed quickly after that.
And I like this. I want to find my running back, but, man, he's got to do a little more damage after the catch. I need a stiff arm. I need a spin move. I need something where he can make that guy miss and pick up a bunch of yards and maybe get a big play out of it.
On third and short, just trying to get enough for the first down. Drills him with a stiff arm. He gets the job done on third down. They move the chains. It's at the 37.
When the running back gets going and gets ahead of steam like that, so hard to get to the ground. That's why you blitz. That's why you bring pressure. That's why you bring more guys in the box so you can get him before he gets going. But once he got going, you could tell it was hard to get a hand on him, hard to get him to the ground.
Looking to go up top on first down. Touchdown, Oklahoma State! And with that, they've got the lead here in the second half.
One of the areas they really focused on with this receiver in the offseason was, we need you to make more plays for us in the end zone. When we're taking shots, we need you to be able to step up and make tough catches. And David, what a grab right there.
And I think a lot of that has to do with trusting your guy, knowing where he's going to be, knowing when he's going to sit down, when he's not. So being on the same page, and then having a guy that can go get it. Just when the ball is near him, he's going to make the play, just like he did right there for 6 points.
Lining up to tack one more onto that lead. And with the extra point, they take a 21-17 lead. So that scoring drive took only 6 plays. And they put the points on the board with that 37-yard touchdown pass. Kickoff team lining up to send this one away. On the move from inside his five. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. BYU has it back. The Cougars ready to get into that playbook. Guys, that last trip a little disappointing, having to take the 3.
Yeah, and I think, Jesse, you see so many offenses talk about getting yards and the tempo and all the stuff they do. It was a nice job moving the football, but they got to get in the end zone this time.
Yeah, and I think to do that, they just got to be more physical at the point of attack, get some push up front. They need to be the best running team in this game to win.
After getting knocked back to open this drive, it's 2nd and 12. Quick strike complete. And good coverage by the defense, just a short gain.
I don't know if that's the coverage you want to be throwing wide receiver screens against. Oftentimes, you want the receivers to have some access. You want the DBs to be off a couple yards so you can help set up the blocks and give the receiver somewhere to go with it. It's hard to run that against press coverage, and they only picked up a few yards there.
On third down, he'll try to pick it up through the air. And that defense gets to him, and down he goes at the 9.
And what a great way to start the second half if you're on defense. You did some really good things in that first half, and so you set the tone here early by getting a sack, and you were sending a clear message to this offense that this second half ain't gonna be easy.
BYU will bring the punt team on the field. Three and out and not much choice but to get rid of the ball. He just wanted to get it out of there from his end zone. He's got great speed, and the punt team able to sling him to the ground. Oklahoma State hoping to get the pistols firing on offense. Boy, David, they would love to stack another touchdown on top of that last drive.
And this offense did such a good job on the last drive. Everything in rhythm, moved the ball down the field, didn't make those mistakes, Jesse, and they need to do it again on this one.
Yeah, you're right. They had the defense on their heels. You wonder what sort of communication was going on that sideline. What sort of changes were they able to make? Because they got to stop the bleeding right now.
The Cowboys are in the hurry up. Dropping back, it's Bowman. He's right on target. And they'll finally get him down after a terrific pickup.
When you play zone coverage and you got a wide receiver that's a beast, it becomes very, very difficult. I got to make sure I play physical and maybe even shade the side of the wide receiver having a lot of success.
Inside the 15, first and 10 from the 14. Running the red zone, it's Gordon. Works his way down to the 10-yard line after a pickup of three. Operating in the red zone here on second down. One running back in the backfield, and he has it. And a decent gain there before the defense makes the stop.
Well, that didn't bust for a long one, but now third down becomes very manageable. It's not third and eternity. Now the whole playbook, short passing game, long passing game, all of it's available.
Boy, they love to move the sticks here and take a shot at it on first and goal. He'll throw on third down. Got it! Takes it to the house! Touchdown, Cowboys! He has been surgical. Precision passes, using the scalpel, the fine instrument, rather than the blunt one.
And the defense has had absolutely no answer for it. Just, he's been down their throats all game long, a step ahead, understanding what he's seeing, and just destroying this defense.
They'll try to add another to their lead. And with the extra point, we have a 28-17 ball game. So the decision has been made, and the coach will take the penalty. They're lining up to kick it off, and he ought to be able to knock this one anywhere he wants after that extra 15 yards with the roughing the kicker. Here comes the offense on first down. Out of the gun, the give to the back. These little gains can start to add up as he gets it up to the 34.
And a nice job by the running back, finding space, getting downhill, making the good run. Great job finishing with his pads.
After the 9-yard pickup on first down, here's second and one. They move the tight end all over. Trying to impose their will with the run. They've pushed it out to the 39 after picking up five.
You know, they pride themselves on being physical at the point of attack, dominating at the line of scrimmage. Nice job there picking up the first down.
From the 39-yard line, it's first and 10. They'll try the run. Keeps the legs moving.
And as an offensive coordinator, you don't need the perfect play with this guy as your running back. He's going to make the play perfect for you because he makes everybody miss. Spin moves, hurdles, stiff arms, speed, whatever it takes to move the sticks and score touchdowns.
They can really be aggressive after that last play at second and three. The give to the tailback. Finally pulled down, but not before moving the chains for a first down.
And listen, the offensive line has to do their job, but a really good job by the running back, understanding where his hole is. Go hit it, get the first down, don't mess around. Nice job following his hole, getting positive yards.
What a day it's been on the ground for these two guys, and they just seem to get stronger as the game goes along as we take a look at the numbers. When you're dealing with a deficit like this, it's all about somebody stepping up to make a play, and you might as well start here in the fourth quarter. Softened him up with a run, and now to throw. A shot toward the end zone. And he's got it! Touchdown, BYU! That big score makes the end of this game very interesting.
No doubt the offense got what they need. More work to do, but you had to get this part accomplished first.
Now they'll try to get the two and make it a three-point game late. Looking to throw. Makes the grab on the left. And they'll knock him down.
I'll tell you, it's tough to complete two-point conversions. Obviously, very small windows to throw into. Couldn't come away with that one. Let's see how that affects the outcome.
About to kick it off after punching it in for the touchdown. Here he comes from inside his own five. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. Oklahoma State has it back, and the offense is on the field. They'll run it from the gun. Powers through the defender. And he'll step across the sidelines after making a good gain on that one.
It's a point in the game, I think, as a coaching staff, where you really challenge your offensive line to go win the football game, right? We've got a lead late. We're going to run the football. And the defense and everybody in the stadium knows that's what's going to happen. Can we run the ball down their throats and impose our will? That's what this offense right now is trying to do.
That play just never had a chance. They knock him down for a loss of five.
Yeah, it's a nice job by this defense. Obviously backed up against it. Time running out. Got to get the football back. Two good plays. Now third down. I stay aggressive. Have to come after him. If they decide to throw the football, so be it. But stay aggressive. Get that football back for your offense.
Fires to the wideout. Wide open downfield. Just what they were looking for to get this drive rolling. They're out to the 35.
Well, this defense has given up some big plays in this game so far, but they've got a lot of talent on that side of the football. Someone has to step up here, make a play, get a stop, and put their team in a position to win.
And the Cowboys have it with a first and 10. Use the play fake, now to throw. Finds his tight end. And he goes out of bounds after a nice pickup on that one.
This is so interesting right now watching this offense stay aggressive. They've got the lead in the fourth quarter, and you're thinking at home, we got to just run the ball and try to bleed the clock. They found something on defense they're taking advantage of. Two straight completions. I won't be surprised if they throw it again.
From the gun, the running back looking for room. Gets it to the 46-yard line. First down for this offense.
And I don't care if I get it by 2, by 20, by 30, by 40. I just want to get the first down, understanding the situation, understanding where the sticks are. Doesn't have to be sexy, but I got to make sure I get to that stick, get to the first down mark.
The Cowboys look to keep this drive humming. They're getting this guy lathered up.
At this point of the game, the offense has the lead, and the offensive coordinator knows they want to keep running the football. So he's going back, he's looking at his playlist, and he's saying, which runs work the best for me in this game? What can I lean on right here to make sure we win this one?
After the productive first down play, it's second and 6. They'll put the tight end in motion. Running to the left. That's what you expect from a senior. Don't give them any extra yards. Great tackle there. This has the makings of a good drive. The seventh play brings up a third and four. Back to throw, it's Bowman. And this sophomore able to wreak some havoc and get the sack.
And how about the strong safety on that blitz? Great job timing it and also getting to the quarterback. Sometimes you're going to have to negotiate around tight ends and running backs, and that strong safety, he just beelined into the backfield.
And the Cowboys send out the punt unit. This will be the second time they've had to kick it away. You'd think they would have had a good chance to down that one deep, but the bounce carries it into the end zone for the touchback. He wants to start this drive with a pass. Got it behind the line. It's Roberts. He's brought down quickly. Minimal gain there. Still a bit short of the first down.
And how about the defense? How big was that stop? Forcing the punt, getting it back to the offense, and all of a sudden, you feel the momentum now on their side.
That completion leaves us with second and medium. Caught in the backfield, it's Hill. Brought down to the ground, but he has enough for the first down.
Nice job decision-making by the quarterback there in the RPO, not handing it off, knowing he had to throw it, but then also understanding his open guy was going to be in the right flat.
They'll snap this one from the 32. It's first down. From the gun, the running back has it. And the defense holds firm. No pickup at all on that play.
How about the defender being a heat-seeking missile? He was on radar lock. He found the football and flew down with some bad intentions.
They got nothing on the last play. It's second and 10. He's looking to throw. Finds his man down the middle. Put it right on him. Sweet play, good pickup, and they'll move the chains with the first down. That was a nice pickup running the drag route and finding that quiet, soft spot in the zone.
Yeah, drag routes not only work against man coverage, they work against zone too. If you can find the soft spot and the quarterback gets it to him early, he can turn up field, and you saw that right there.
Going up top on first down, using the quick game.
You know, the defense doesn't have an answer for this slot guy right now. They may want to think about bracketing him, having a defender play to the outside and to the inside, probably some sort of zone coverage where you're trying to get two bodies, forcing the quarterback to have to go somewhere else with the ball.
Second down here, and maybe they've got time to get one more snap off before the two-minute warning. Gonna run it. It's Martin. They knock him down at the 40. It's a pickup of five, and that will be enough for a first down. The Cougars come to the line with a new set of downs. They'll throw it on first down. Gets it out quickly. They get him down after he makes a catch.
Defense comes up with a really big stop there. That's nice. They don't give up the first down, so the clock keeps working, but they're on their own end of the field. They know this offense is going to start taking shots into the end zone. They better have some guys ready on the back end, ready to swat some balls away and make some plays.
Right on target with that last pass. Now it's second and medium. Oh, what a spectacular layout and catch. Quick timeout call by the offense after the play, trying to preserve every minute possible. From the 22 on first and 10. He's gonna pass. He finds his man.
Well, they don't pick up the first down there, but in this two-minute situation, they need their quarterback to be decisive, to be accurate, and make really good decisions. And we'll see what he's able to do as they inch closer and closer towards the goal line.
Going to work on second down in the red zone, is still some ground to cover to pick up that first down. The sweet feet keeping the play alive. He saw just enough daylight to move the sticks and get it done with his legs.
It's just so nice as a coaching staff when you've got quarterbacks who make good decisions. And on a second and short play, you're throwing it, you're trying to catch the defense napping, you might take a shot, nothing there. Go get it yourself. Make the right decision to keep it, not panic, and get you a fresh set of downs.
Grabbed in the middle, it's Roberts. Good throw and catch, takes it down to the five as the offense tries to cash in.
Man, it's so important when you play QB. I got to know when to put some air on it, and I got to know when to rocket that thing in there. Work in the middle of the field. He knew he needed the rocket. Threw it in there. Great job. Great catch.
On second down, he'll fire. And he just threw that one away. Safe move. Didn't see anything. Lived to play another play.
Man, this late in the game, it's go time. I got to have a score. I'm not worried about downs. I'm going through my two-minute script. We know what's coming. We practiced this all week. It's second down, incomplete pass, go to third down. If we need to go for it on fourth down, this offense just has to keep that high energy up and try to run these plays fast.
And he can't find his man in the end zone as he was trying to pay off this red zone chance.
After that incompletion, there is so much pressure now on this quarterback to come up with a big play. They need to score a touchdown. They need to keep this drive alive to have any shot at winning this game. But it all comes down to this play right here.
Down a possession here in the fourth, and they'll need to convert on this fourth down. Unleashes to the end zone. Touchdown, Cougars! And they've got the lead in the final minute.
Man, this game has been incredible to watch, and the offense comes through late in the game, takes the lead. What a clutch drive by this offense. Now, I'm looking at you, defense. You got the lead late in the game. I need you to go put this thing on ice and win it for me.
Up by one, they're going to try to get the deuce here and make it a field goal lead. Takes a snap, wants to throw. He gets into the end zone for the two-point conversion, and the cushion is now three. Lining up to cover the kick after that touchdown drive. Looking for an alley from inside his own 10. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. They've got to move quickly here. Still a chance, but they've got to force the ball down the field. Caught over the middle. It's Andrews. Timeout is called. Clock stops. 13 seconds to go in the game. Got to get everybody lined up quickly. Time winding away, and they've got to push the ball down the field. To the air on first down. Looking to the big tight end. Passes incomplete. The clock is down to 9.
This really has been a masterclass by the quarterback with decision-making, right? We've already seen him throw multiple touchdown passes in the game. He's understood when to take his shots and when to throw it away when things aren't there, like on that last play.
No time to waste here. They've got to get set and pick up chunk yardage. Looking for a man. It's Bowman. They're working that left side. Timeout on the field and 4 ticks left to go. They've got to move quickly here. Still a chance, but they've got to force the ball down the field. On third and short, they'll try to throw for it. And the ball is intercepted. Didn't have a lot of room to run after the pick, but he's done his job. They have it at the 44.
When you're down late in the game, you got to make plays. It's really tough not to force the football. You can tell. Quarterback forces the football. Defense comes up with a huge interception.
So with the late lead, they're ready to just drain the clock in victory formation. And the quarterback's just going to take a knee.